gone are the days when you go out and buy SSD, and it would be cooler than a traditional hard drive. With 3rd gen, 4th gen, and now 5th gen SSDs getting hotter and hotter, some even hotter than CPUs, you sometimes need some additional cooling. And this is where this product from Arctic comes in. It's quite compact, you can use it in a PC, most laptops, and even some game consoles. The Arctic M.2 Pro is a versatile M.2 SSD cooler, available in black and silver. Designed to prevent overheating, it features a high-quality aluminium heatsink that efficiently dissipates heat, ensuring your SSD operates at normal temperatures. The packaging is straightforward, providing necessary information on the front, including a 6-year warranty. However, it lacks an image of the actual product. There is a QR code on the back for the manual, but it didn't seem to work for us, or at least at the time of testing. Inside the box, you'll find the cooler and the actual thermal pads, but other than that, that's it. The Arctic M.2 Pro consists of 4 parts. The base, which is made of aluminium, a thermal pad for below the SSD, a thermal pad for above the SSD, and the top part of the heatsink, which is also aluminium. Setup is easy, but test the fit before sealing the actual unit. Depending on your motherboard, the M.2 socket or screw holes may impede installation if the cooler isn't installed correctly. First of all, get the base and add the thermal pad, obviously removing the protective strips. Then add the SSD to the base, ensuring the pins and screw holes are exposed at both ends, and check the fit on your motherboard before sealing the unit. Now add the second thermal pad on top of the SSD and attach the top of the heatsink by either pressing firmly on the top or turning it upside down and pressing down on the bottom. Now, to install it into the PC, all you have to do is basically attach it into the M.2 socket on your board and then screw it in. Removing the cooler from the SSD requires a small flat screwdriver, but be careful as it's easy to scratch the aluminium on the heatsink. Even on Arctic's own installation video, it shows scratches when they remove the actual casing from the SSD. However, these marks are usually not visible once installed in the PC. You'll likely need new thermal pads if you plan on installing a new SSD at a later date. So down to testing, first of all, the room temperature is 21.5 degrees C. We use exactly the same components on here. The only thing we change is obviously the heatsink when we're doing the testing. And to do the testing, we are comparing the temperatures between having no heatsink on the SSD to one what's built into the motherboard, as well as the Arctic cooler. And then we're going to be testing them with and without direct airflow. In this test, we're looking at the average temperature of the SSD. And as you can see here, the Arctic cooler came in at 67 degrees. That's compared to 74 degrees without a heatsink. The one with the motherboard actually comes in at 57, so that actually wins out. But again, if you don't have a heatsink built into your motherboard, then the Arctic is definitely a good choice. It does reduce temperatures by a bit. Obviously, if you've got direct airflow onto your heatsink, so a fan blowing directly onto it, it will reduce the temperatures even more. On this next test, we're doing exactly the same again, but we're looking at the maximum temperature the actual SSD got up to. And as you can see here, with no heatsink, we got 77 degrees. With the Arctic cooler heatsink, we got 71 degrees. And if you add a fan into the mix, we got 48 degrees. Again, this really depends on your airflow in your case, because in some cases, your SSD will be under a graphics card and not getting a lot of airflow. In other cases, it might have lots of fans blowing at it, keeping it cool. In this test, we're actually looking at the temperature of the SSD 15 seconds after a 30 minutes worth of work. This demonstrates how quickly the SSD will cool down, and as you can see here, in 15 seconds it drops to 44 degrees if you're using the Arctic cooler, and if you're not using a cooler, you're looking at 58 degrees. We did also do tests to see the speed differences between the SSD with a cooler or not, but we found very little or no difference. But again, this can differ per SSD you're using, and again, the amount of airflow you have got. So in conclusion, depending on your cooling setup and SSD, the Arctic M.2 Pro could help keep your SSD cool, improving its performance and longevity. By maintaining optimal temperatures, this cooler ensures your SSD runs better and lasts longer, making it a valuable addition to your PC build. I hope you enjoyed this video, and know I did. Why not check out one of our other videos by clicking this box up here, or this one just down here. Otherwise, you can give us a thumbs up, like, subscribe, comment below, let us know what you think, and we'll see you next time.